just gonna do a little video for posting later. It's 7:18 in the morning. I am on like 3 hours of sleep, but fortunately I got a wind. So that's a relief. It was really, really difficult starting out at 4 o'clock this morning because it was really dark and I was exhausted and fighting to, you know, be conscious. But I made it, and we just stopped at, we're around Champaign, Illinois right now, and we just stopped in a McDonald's down the way in the middle of a cornfield. You know, there's like a little thing that opens up, and there's a McDonald's and a gas station, and I met a man in there that has an Eclipse 2017 t-shirt. Dude's already got the t-shirt, but it was like, yo. And then I met a dad and his young daughter and her friend, looks like her friend, and they are from outside of Chicago. And the girl who was working the counter asked if I was traveling, and I said, yes, we're traveling. And she said, because they've been super busy today, which I guess is unusual. They've probably like quadrupled the amount of business so far, and it's only 7:20 in the morning, so when I tell people where we're from, I say we're from the Catskill Mountains of New York, their jaws drop. Like, they can't believe how far we are from home. And I can't either, really. But, just a short little video. You know, it's totally overcast. We just went through, like, pea soup, thick fog. You could barely see like a car length in front of you, and but we got through that. The fog seems to be burning off. The temperature's gone up 3 degrees. It was 70, now it's 73, and we got like 7.3 miles to go, and then we're gonna turn on I-74. I took Illinois South, the Route 59 South to start out. Before I put the GPS on, I took 59 all the way down because I did not want the GPS to bring me anywhere near Chicago. I was done with driving near Chicago. So now we're here. This is what it looks like. I wish that I had the camera out before because we went through a really beautiful landscape at sunrise with a bunch of wind turbines. And just, you know, that it's that whole iconic huge field, you know, where you can almost see the curvature of the earth, and the wind turbines were glowing in the rising sunlight, kind of glowing orange all over the white turbines. It was pretty majestic. I haven't seen a sunrise since I worked nights at David's Potbelly Stove on Christopher Street. And believe me, I'm not, you know, I'm not a fan of sunrise. You can give me a sunset any day. But it was pretty cool. Co-pilot. Alright, let me turn this off and keep on trucking. See you later. Well, I'm just doing a little update here. It's 7:31, and we just got on to 74, which is, you know, even numbers go east-west and odd numbers go north-south. And I just saw one of those signs, you know, the LED light signs, and it said traffic delays possible through August 22nd, solar eclipse August 21st. Oh, yeah. All right, well, it's 7:30 in the morning. Hopefully everybody's waiting till the last minute. I mean, I expected that. I've been reading about this for 2 solid years, so... Makes me almost wish I had an iPhone or something like that so I could go on Google Maps and check the traffic pattern and all that. But, you know, hey, we're out here and we're doing it anyway. Came all this way. It's overcast. You know, what are you gonna do? Just gotta keep driving. So, that's what we're doing. Shit, and looks like we gotta merge. Alright, bye. Well, you know, I'm sitting here, it's 8:30, trying to chill. Still have like 66 miles to go. Look at what the state of Illinois plans. Now, you know that everybody has known about this eclipse for at least a year. And look at what the state of Illinois does. They close down the right lane. This is like miles that right here on I-57 South. The whole entire right lane is completely closed down because they're doing road work. And there's not even anybody here doing the road work. So what kind of planning is that? This is what I want to know. What kind of planning when you know that your state is on the center line of like one of the most epic events, you know, celestial events in the entire country, and then you're going to go and do this and effing dig up one whole entire side of the highway so traffic can be backed up for miles and miles and miles. And creepy crawling at like 8 miles an hour. They knew that these roads were going to be heavily trafficked today. And they go and do this. What kind of damn sense does this make? Now I'm thinking to myself, you know, because when we went to the Chicago Cultural Center, the woman who was our tour guide from the Chicago Greeters had said, you know, because we were in the, you know, in the cultural center and there was a United States flag and then the other flag was the Chicago flag. And she says Chicagoans do not consider themselves part of the state of Illinois, you know, and not that they would secede because, like, you know, secession never works. But now I understand why Chicagoans do not consider themselves part of this state. Because I think Chicagoans are a little bit more sophisticated and would think ahead and never do some dumb shit like this. So anyway, damn. I mean, that's kind of like, you know, that's kind of like the state of Illinois just flipping the bird to everybody. Yeah, we know there's going to be like an extra 3 million people coming to our state to see this eclipse. Let's just flip them all the bird and let them know how we feel about them. That's what this says to me. Bullshit. All right, well, and the sky is cloudy.
Well, it's clearing out.
Look at this. Well, ha, ha. The one who always has something down to say is being the optimist here. God.
Because it is. I'm like actually looking.
I swear to God, we can never be on the same side of the coin. You know what I'm saying?
Reunion.
I'm feeling damn pessimistic right now. And he's Mr. Hopeful. Jesus. And every time I'm Ms. Hopeful, he's Mr. Not Hopeful. So, whatever. And God help me if I can find a radio station in this part of the world. They just yap, 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 yap. That's all they're doing right now. So we're just creepy crawling in the traffic. 66 miles before I can even think of turning off so I can go to Paducah. And it's supposed to always be sunny in Paducah, but I don't know about today. It's just a waiting game. And it was like 3 hours and 20 minutes exactly until first contact starts. That's when you first see the shadow move across the sun. That's like, boop, that's where the edge touches the edge. And that's going to go on for like an hour and a half, I think. I have all the times written down. And then will be the total. Man, the universe is keeping me on the edge of my seat. And I don't like it. All right, bye. Okay, now people, 8:55 in the morning, here's a little bitty update. My son and I have just had a rousing discussion about the importance of having more than one tool at your disposal. Because everybody, I think, is listening to their GPS, but let's see what? You need to have a good old-fashioned map with you too, because the GPS keeps trying to route us back to 57. The traffic is backed up for like 5 miles, and I'm not even kidding. It's creeping in one lane. But see, we found Route 45 south that goes all the way down to Route 24, which is what we need to take so we can get to our hotel in Paducah, Kentucky. Now you see, this GPS is going to try to route us back to I-57. Now, if we were to listen to that, we would wind up back in that goddamn gridlock. Excuse my French. But see, we got a map and we found Route 45. We traced it all the way down and we can take this all the way to 24. So, you know, technology is good, but I'm saying get yourself a good old-fashioned map. And learn how to read it, okay? Now we're on 45 South. I don't know how long it's going to take us because it's, you know, it's kind of like for New York State, it's like 9W. You know, there's going to be stoplights and stuff. But we ain't going to be sitting in that shit. Mama say, yo, rocking it out, hip-hopping all the way down to Paducah. We coming, baby. Bye. Oh my God, look at the triumphant. Look at, we got this highway all to ourselves, pretty much. Oh my God, yes, 45 South, 45. Now, didn't I tell some of you people that 45, I'm 45, we live on Route 45 in Ulster County, and 45 is my son's favorite number. 45, 45. 45. I'm liking it. We can take this all the way down. We figured out to Route 24, which is what we need to get on to get to our hotel in Paducah, Kentucky. And look at this. And the sun, the clouds have parted. Man, we did so good. Me and Chabayo, we are good traveling companions. And thank you to the Rand McNally Atlas. Ha! Alright, more later. I'm gonna post all this stuff later, but this is what we've been through. And I don't care, 50 miles an hour, I'm saying we'll see more things. And the feeling of freedom, of just being able to move forward. Now, you can take that in any direction that you want, but that feeling of freedom to be able to move forward, I am all about that. Mwah. All right, I'm going to do a little progress report here. It's 10:59 and we're still on 45. But here's the thing. I had bought that book by Fred Espenak for $35. And let me tell you, that book is worth every penny. I stayed up every night for like a month, like obsessing and poring over that book and over the road atlas, and I managed to mark off in pencil like this wide circle of the Totality Band in Southern Illinois, and also where the band of Totality fell in Kentucky. And here's the thing. There's a lot of people like speeding past us because my intuition is telling me that these people only know of, like, you know, they've only heard of Carbondale, which has been like highly publicized as the place to see the eclipse. But the eclipse is a very wide area where you can see Totality. So my son and I, and Chamayo, you and I, if you're watching this years from now, we have teamed up and he has the map. You better open your eyes, shit. He has the map, and as we're passing the towns on Route 45, he's watching on the map for the place names, for the town names, that are within that band of Totality that I have circled on the road atlas. So, we don't have to get to Paducah, to our hotel, to see Totality. And we have like another 50 minutes before first contact. And then after first contact, it's like a whole nother hour at least, something like that, until Totality. So as long as we've managed to get down 45 close enough inside the Totality band, we can see the whole thing. So that's basically what we've come to, that as long as we get in that band, we're gonna see it. So yeah, and that's where we are now. Bye. It's 11:24 a.m. and we're on 45. Oh, and we're getting so close to the Totality band. Oh my God, my heart is just like pounding with excitement. And about 11:51, that's just when first contact is. And that whole process is gonna go on for about an hour before Totality. For actual Totality. So Chamayo and I have made an agreement that, you know, we're gonna drive. We're just gonna keep driving through the first contact and see where we end up. But we still have 30 minutes before first contact. So I'm just driving and we're gonna see where we end up. We have our coolers, we got a blanket, we got pillows. I got my yoga mat, my yoga block. We can just pull off to the side of the road and do it like that. All right, I'll check in again.
Got it. There you go. Look in it.
Just turn it on?
Yeah.
Okay, good. No, I'll look later. I don't want to touch it. Look,
pain in the ass. it's still on there.
Let it be.
t-shirts and frame